Wesley's historic questions were about what to teach, how to teach, and what to do. For this interval of features for the Connectional Tables Emerging Forum, we will seek to update these questions for our current moment. We will invite energetic conversation that will illumine our identity, which is tied to what and how we teach, our preferred actions, what we do, and our abiding hopes as we envision the future United Methodist Church. Our intent is to generate passion and energy for constructive conversations that help us walk forward together. Today, I am joined by Bishop Gregory Palmer, the Bishop of the West Ohio Annual Conference. Good afternoon, Bishop Palmer.
Good afternoon. It's great to be with you, and thanks for this opportunity.
And it's wonderful to be with you. Thank you for making the time out of your busy schedule. We're going to start with just kind of talking about some issues around identity and who we are as United Methodists. What are the core principles that you believe shape who we are as United Methodist Christians?
Thanks for that question. I think it's my belief that, and I'm sort of looking over a longer stream of history, so I'm thinking from the beginning till now, and I'm not suggesting that they are different, but I'm leaving openness that they may have evolved or some things may have gone to the wayside. But I believe that United Methodists and all the streams that form United Methodists have been shaped by a belief that grace is for all, that salvation is extended by God in Christ Jesus in the power of the Holy Spirit for all people everywhere. And secondly, I believe that we've been shaped in terms of principles and values by connection. That's been hugely defining, I believe, from the beginning until now. It doesn't mean there haven't been any stress points. I think that we have held as a core value our ecumenicity, and let me sort of just tease out, the spirit of Mr. Wesley and his notion of Catholic spirit would be, I think, an undergirding theme for him about how we approach the ecumenical and I would say interfaith relationships and work. Fourthly, we are shaped and defined identity-wise by a conviction, and I believe practice, not perfect practice, about engagement in the world and in the communities where we are. And I think that goes to our deepest roots. A contemporary way of putting that might be to say we believe and affirm in contextual ministry. But I want to talk about engagement with our communities and the world. So we might also put the label mission on that. So I think those are four key definers of us.
Well, when you think about those key definers, you know, you talked about grace, you talked about mission and engagement, you talked about evangelism, bringing people to Christ, this outreaching message of the love of God for all people. How does that become real through the ministry of the local church? What do people see United Methodists doing and saying that point to those key identity markers that you mentioned?
I think one of the things that the world outside of United Methodism would see among some of the things I've listed is the care that many, if not most, United Methodist local congregations have in terms of engaging their communities. Now, I don't think it's as even as it could or should be, because there have been periods, and we might be in one of them now, where local congregations have kind of gone into the bunker. They've turned in to say, well, who's going to take care of us? But when we are at our best, and when people that, let's say, are not United Methodists, and maybe not even people of Christian faith or of any particular faith, say, you know, those United Methodists, they do these things. I thrill when I run into someone that is not a United Methodist, that identifies a quality and a characteristic that says we were engaged in the community, in the neighborhood, and in the world. I would say writ large, we see it in our response to huge crises and disaster response, and I would say other crises as well. And so I think that's a plus. I think we've been known across time for being in lots of places, and I want to say particularly in the United States, but underscoring that we're a global church. But you know, that whole analogy that was made several decades ago, that there are as many, if not more, local United Methodist churches as there are United States post offices. I don't think that's quite as true as it is, as it might have been 25 years ago. But presence and identity in those communities are ways in which people have marked us.
Yeah. Now you mentioned with local churches that sometimes there's a tendency to turn inward, and that certainly has been an issue that we've tried to address in terms of church vitality. How do you feel this pandemic has impacted that?
I think there's been some, let me say, some give and some take on that. When I talk to individual United Methodists and leaders of congregations in West Ohio, I hear extraordinary things. And particularly, but not exclusively, but there's a retired layman in this conference. And at the beginning of the pandemic, I was talking with him because he chairs a committee in the annual conference. And we were trying to set up a meeting to, you know, kind of keep in touch about the work of that committee. And he said, well, I can't do it at this time, Bishop, and I can't do it at that time because my wife and I, we have an ongoing commitment of being at the food pantry where we serve people in need. So I said, well, dude, how's that working in the pandemic? I mean, he's mid-70s, he and his wife both. So they hit all of the bells of categories of vulnerability, at least by age, some by health conditions. And he said, you know, we put our masks on, we get our sanitizer, you know, we set up the space differently along with our other volunteer peers, but we're just not backing off of serving the most vulnerable. I want to say that story has been repeated over and over and over and over again in this pandemic. And I'm talking at the volunteer level. I'm not even speaking about the people that have to go to work. Let's say those in the medical community or people that are first responders that keep showing up. And a part of it is, I mean, it's their job, it's their skill set, but it's more that it's their vocation and they cannot bear to watch people being that vulnerable to this virus. So United Methodists and United Methodist congregations have continued to keep serving. Even when they've gone to all online worship, their giveaway serving, direct service needs ministries are still going. And sometimes that's done ecumenically. That's a great source of pride.